So, can anyone help me with this?
Sure, here we have this double integral, and it says, do I really have to find the integral of 1 over x to the 5th power plus 1, or is there an easier way? There is an easier way. Because right now, if you look at this integral because we have the dx going first, we would really have to integrate a constant over x to the 5th power plus 1, which is not a good idea. However, if we can switch the order of the differential, sometimes we'll have a better chance, just like this right here. So to work that out, let's sketch the region first. We have dx, so that means x is going from 1 to square root of y. And let's look at how that is going to be. Here is x is equal to 1, it's just a vertical line. And because this is down here, so we have to start right here. And you can imagine that you are standing right here on the curve, and you will have to look at to the right for the right end bound. But here's a tricky part though. The next thing is that x is equal to square root of y, and if you just make a quick graph of it, square both sides, you can see that's the same as y equals x squared, and you just care about the right side. So it's like this usually, but now we just want this right here, right? And this is x equals square root of y. It's like going up. Remember, we are right here at first, and we are looking at the right. Unfortunately, there is no right end bound for us. So that's kind of strange. Well, in this case, what we are going to do is, not only we are going to switch the dx dy, but also we will have to switch the 1 and also the square root of y. Because technically, we should be right here first, and then look at the right bound. Now, let's see how we can switch the 1 and also the square root of y. The first integral stays, but the next one, I will have the square root of y down here and then the 1 up here. This is not bad because all we have to do is just negate the result, right? That's one of the properties from integrations that we learn in Calc 1. Put a negative, but that's just like multiply by negative 1, so I can put it on the outside like this. And then the rest, I'll just keep it the same. Dx, dy. Now, right here, we are no longer standing right here first because we have the square root of y going first. So we are looking at from here and then look at to the right, and this right here is the right bound. Right, this is the left end bound, this is the right end bound. Now, the bottom bound is when we have y is equal to 0, which is this right here. And then we are going to go up to y is equal to 1, which happens to be right here. So this is the region that we want. So this is like a little curvy triangle thing. Okay, so now this is the moment that we are going to switch the order of the integration. I'm going to put the red one on the outside and then the black one inside. And this is still going to be negated. And then right here, the integrand stays the same, but we want to have the dy going first and then the dx on our side. So what we are going to do is we are looking at the y, which starts on the bottom, so that will be 0. And then we're going to go up till this becomes our upper bound. And the y equation for that is y equals x squared. Just square both sides for that. So from 0 to x squared. Like that. And then for the x, well, we are looking at the starting left end, which is right here, 0, go up to here, which is 1. So 0 to 1, just like that. Now, if we look at this integral here, we just have to integrate y in the y world. The 1 over x to the 5th power can be put in the front a little bit, but not on the very outside though, just like this. Negative integral from 0 to 1, put the 1 over x to the 5th power plus 1 here, and then focus on integrating y dy first, like this. If you're comfortable of doing the integral with this, you can just add 1 to the power and then divide it by the new power, and it can work out. Or sometimes it might be easier if you write it down like this, so it's kind of up to you. I'm going to just work out like this, so I'm going to erase this right here. And I'm also going to be erasing this right here. Okay, so the outside stays the same, and integrating, we just care about the y in the y world, so that will be 1 over 2 y squared, and then we have to go from 0 to x squared. And remember, we still have that 1 over x to the fifth power plus 1 like this, it's multiplying with that, and then we have the dx. Now, when we're plugging x squared into here, this is just going to be the following. Still have the negative on the outside. That will give us x to the fourth power on the top. Over, we have the 1/2, maybe put that in the front right here as well. And then we have x to the fifth power plus 1. And we are doing this in the x world. Now, integrate this, we can just do a quick use up. Let u equal x to the fifth power plus 1. Du is 5x to the fourth dx. Here, we have x to the fourth, but we need a 5. Let's multiply this by 5, and then let's go ahead and divide it by that right here. So this is like our du, and this is the u. So, multiply the constants, we have negative 1 over 10, and we just have to integrate, and that's going to be 1 over u in the u world. Also, if you take this to u world, make sure you change the numbers here as well. When x is equal to 1, u will be, when x is equal to 0, u will be 0 to the 5th plus 1, so it's 1. And then when x is equal to 1, u will be 1 to the 5th, which is 1 plus 1, which is 2. And then just finish it. This is negative 1 over 10. This is going to be ln. You don't need the absolute value because we are just looking at from positive 1 to positive 2. And then we go from 1 to 2. Plugging 2 and plugging 1. So 1 over 10, negative 1 over 10. And then we have ln 2. And then this is the first part minus the second part, which is going to be 0, but I'll still show you the work like this. Ln 1 is 0, so the whole thing here is 0. So that's the answer. We have negative 1 over 10 ln 2, just like this.